Hey there, Absolutely Gospel Music fans. We are here with Karen Peck New River. And I've never interviewed you that far away, but we'll make long distance work.
Do you want me to swear again? Yeah.
No, we're social distancing right now.
That's it.
Well, Karen, it's been a while since we've talked. And I think you have one new guy since the last time we talked.
Well, Grant's been with us now 3.5 years. Yeah. So it's been a while. I remember us. Listen, let me just say this about you and your family. Y'all have been so good to New River and absolutelygospel.com. You all have been such a blessing to us. And I say this often, but even many, many years ago, we were, you know, releasing songs to radio, and they may not go to number one, or they may stay in top 10 or whatever, but you all always recognized the more progressive songs on our records. And you all, and I just remember one day, one of our songs had won the Progressive Song of the Year, and I can remember thinking, oh, thank you, Lord, someone is noticing. And it was you all, and thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We'll never forget
privilege.
It. You're a blessing.
And you know, you have to understand, that was a few years ago when my son was a lot younger. And I had to do that because he said he was going to marry you.
Oh, he's so sweet. I love Chris.
Yes, we know Chris and Amy.
Chris
and Amy.
And I met Chris at a Christian bookstore right there in Murfreesboro. I had stopped to get, one of the Nicole C. Mullins song. And I stopped there to get it because I had a long drive home. And there was Chris. So it was pretty awesome.
Yeah, he was pretty much just out of high school then. So.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yes. In fact, we promoted a concert with you when we were in Mississippi.
Yes, you did. Yes. That's right in your family side.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That was a good memory. Very good
memory.
Well,
I'm glad it was good.
Good.
Yeah. Well, what's been happening with you? I mean, it's been a long couple of years through this COVID stuff and everything. So what's been going on?
Well, we've had a lot of things to happen. I mean, a lot of heartache, but then a lot of victories as well. And God is teaching us to persevere. And, you know, he commands us in Revelation to persevere. And so we've been persevering, and it's been a good thing. It's been great being back on the road. We are now looking, finalizing our songs for a new record and for a 2022 release. So we have a lot of great things, great concerts, and honestly, it feels good to be back on the road.
That's good.
Full time, all the time.
That's good. So, Susan, it's been a long journey for you too, right?
Oh yes.
What's it been like traveling with your sister all these years?
You have to tell them what you tell.
Well, you know, I told them. I tell people. This lady came up to the table. She said, "What is it like traveling with your sister?" She said, "I just cannot get along with mine. There's no way." And I looked at her and I said, "Well, it's kind of like a marriage. You're in it for the long haul. You don't have a choice, so you just go on." But I'm blessed to be able to travel.
That's true. You can't divorce your sister.
No, you can't.
She stuck with me.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
Yeah, but I love it. I'm very blessed to be able to travel with her.
Well, that's good.
We got a great team right now with all these young people. And, you know,
all these young people.
Yeah, Deon, we're split down the middle. We call them the millennials, and they call us the boomers.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you this.
Didn't call you the geriatrics.
Well, there you go. Susan and I agree that the boomers are a lot smarter.
Oh, yes. You got my vote here.
Yes.
So, that was it? You're just much smarter?
Yeah.
I was thinking you might take that someplace else. So you tell me, what's it like to sing with your mother and be so much younger than
them? It's a lot of fun. They keep us on our toes, you know, and there's always something going on. But we have a good time.
We try to keep up with them, make sure they don't just like,
they
wander off on us.
That's true.
Make sure they take their medicine every night. Honestly, it's a full-time job.
Yeah, yeah. It's like a nursing home.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, man. I'm older than either one of them. Now you're really older.
They went meddling now, didn't they?
Yeah. So what's it like traveling with your sister?
My sister?
Yeah.
you know, I just try to survive.
We don't fight that often.
No, she picks on me all the time. You know, she steals my seat on the bus all the time.
No.
She
steals my seat.
You know, it's one of those things. I'm just surviving.
You know, I think the average person that looks at this group, they look at Matt and think that he was the one that picks on her. But it's really the other
really
way around. It really is. Wow. She's the bully on the bus. So she picks on all of us.
Yeah. Don't listen to anything.
So tell me, Karen, how is ministry, I'm going in a real logical move here. You know,
yeah.
Anyway, what's it like ministry-wise after COVID?
Well, I'll tell you, God has definitely deepened our ministry. I feel like there's so many people that have been through hard times, the hardest times that we've ever known. And of course, we're all in uncharted waters. So we've never been in a pandemic, a worldwide pandemic before. So I think that God shifted us. I think He has shifted the church. But I believe that that now more than ever, we have got to get the word of hope out because people are desperate for God to move.
Yes.
I guess that's probably the word that I can say. With everywhere we go, every single night, we can see the desperation on people's faces. They're desperate for God. And we've been down that road. So I think that's really what's happening. And I really think all of the writers are writing greater songs. And, you know, through the greatest trials become the greatest blessings.
Well, they went through them, too.
Yeah. And so I really believe that now, more than ever, that the church is going to rise up. And I really believe that God has a purpose. And I said if he allows it to happen, He will get us through it. He's not the limits.
Right.
So, but we, you know, I really feel like even the songs that we've picked out for our new record, they're just next level songs.
Okay. I wasn't ready for you to stop because I had a thought in your mouth.
Yeah.
Don't get old. Just
Oh, no. But also I will say this too, the writing, even the writing sessions for our songs. I mean,
yep.
It's really been something. I mean, honestly, and I know what you're thinking, Matthew, that I was in, had COVID last year in 2020, June of 2020, I had COVID and no one else had COVID. And I didn't even know how I had COVID. I didn't even know anyone had COVID. And I can remember once I got through the initial just very tired and being very sick, I said, you know what, I'm going to write my way through this. So I started calling up my writer friends and started writing songs through this pandemic. And Matthew, I know what you're going to say, we went to our song listening session, and I was absolutely so excited about some of these songs, and then you tell me about it.
Some of those songs were not.
Whoa.
But they were good.
I would never say that.
They were good.
They were good. They were what we were looking for.
Yeah, that's it.
So what that brings me to who I was going to ask, how many songs do
you have? On this, the new one is, you know what, I'm not really into it. Well, I don't, let's see. I'm not sure that we'll record all 10 of mine.
Well,
wait, but there are a couple that will be down.
Two possibilities.
10 songs.
Yeah. That's good.
But I've got great writers like Dave Clark, Ken West, Tony Wood, Michael Ferry. Oh my goodness, Seuss's hit. The song, the list just goes on. But it's, and Jason Cox, of course. But it's, but the list goes on of these writers. John Darren Rousey, who wrote a song called Not For Long. And it's just a smash. It's a smash hit. And so I don't know if we're going to record it or the Guardians are going to record it, but one of us will because it sure is. Both of us wrote that song while we were experiencing COVID. At the time, he had I was coming out of COVID, and then he was going into COVID, and we FaceTimed a writing session, and it was very special.
That's good.
I have to say too, like, yeah, whenever she brought those songs, like, some of them, you know, we didn't like, but there were songs in that pile that were amazing songs.
Well, don't forget, you know, there's a little song that you guys recorded, and this writer sent it to a whole bunch of other writers, and they didn't want it. They just turned it down. And then your mother recorded 4 days late.
That's true. Yes.
So what you think right now is not really something. Give it a little bit. You know, it might just.
You never know.
That's it.
Might just turn into something.
It's amazing how you just open your heart and your mind and just pray for God to send it. He will send us the right songs.
That's right.
Literally. Yeah. At the right time. And that's, we're living proof of that.
Yes. Really completely off what we were talking about, but I know you were friends with Jeff Dice.
Oh.
And how did that affect you?
You know what? It's still so surreal to me. I can't believe it. I really can't even imagine. You know, it's like, it's just to think that Jeff's in heaven now, which yay for him, but sad for us.
Yeah.
It's just, I just cannot believe it. Kelly Nealon, she had kept me up to date on what was happening with him. And you know, of course, he traveled with the Nealons a lot. And so it was just heartbreaking. You know,
and it happened so fast.
It did. It, honestly, our industry will never be the same with him not here. But it's just, matter of fact, at the National Quartet Convention, one night I was looking, just talking to someone at my table and looking, you know, straight down the aisle, and I caught eye of somebody, and I thought for a split second, oh, it looks like Jeff, and I think he's not here. Jeff Dice, he made a huge impact on my life and on this industry.
Anything that you would like, or any of you would like to say to the people watching? You know, every time I say this, they get up there and they sit back in the seats and they see you up there, and it's just so great. You know, I mean, life is, how could life get any better than that? You know, and they don't think you had COVID. They don't think that you lost your dear friend. So tell us a little bit about how you're just like everybody else.
Well, and you know, a lot of times people think that we don't have troubles, but honestly, we do, and that we have to get on that bus every single week. But we want to encourage all of you that are watching to be encouraged in the Lord and know that Jesus loves you and He cares. And whatever you're facing right now, you will make it through. The Lord is with you and He cares. And we do ask that you pray for us too. Sometimes it's not easy getting on that bus because we don't, at this point, things are different. Life is different. And it's not pre-COVID, pre-pandemic. Things are not the same as before. But you know what? One thing that we learned, I said this a long time ago, that things may not be the same, but they can still be good.
That's right.
And maybe everybody should say something. Why don't you say your thoughts as well? Expound on that.
Expound on what you just said?
Yes. Because I'm talking so much.
Okay, well, your name is on the group, so. I would just say, you know, with what you just said, just be encouraged that each and every one of us over the past year and a half have been through things too. And, you know, God's in control and He has it.
Yes.
And He sees.
Yes, and it might seem like that you've been waiting and waiting and waiting and you've not getting any answers, but God's still there. He still loves you. And just keep persevering because He will answer your prayers.
Yeah, and just stay focused on God. You know, that's what we have to do every single day.
And one thing Mom and I have tried to do that we've learned helps is to stay in the Word. You know, we try to watch sermons and even on TV if we're not able to go to our church, but to watch sermons and be encouraged that way. And that kind of helps shift your focus on the important.
Well, it's been fun interviewing everybody.
Yeah, thank you, Deon.
Some more than others, you know. But
yes, obviously.
Deon, we thank you so much. You are a dear friend to us. We love
you. And I consider you a dear friend, too. You know, you've